You got 10 cents?
Yeah. Why?
I want you to make a phone call. You're off your break before. It'll be easier than I thought. Give me the doctor's number, right?
What'll I say?
You don't have to say anything.
Oh, just do it.
All right.
I'm not sure I'm safe alone with you.
Oh, that phone keeps ringing the way it usually does. You're perfectly safe.
Oh, it won't, will it? It's after hours.
Is your idea to stay home?
If we drink anymore, I think we should eat.
Oh, now there speaks a wife.
Can I change my mind about going out for dinner?
For you, my darling, anything. I'll phone Jules at the Dorset, see if he can book a table.
What about the little Italian place?
Well, it's only a calf.
It'd be lovely.
I love you. See what I mean?
You want me to get it?
Severe. Also, multiple head injuries. As you probably saw, she took the full force of the blast down her right side. There's considerable damage to the thoracic region, fragments in the right lung. Probably more elsewhere. Can't tell yet. Don't worry. We'll do our best.
Mrs. Healy, how are you?
Macaulay.
Pardon?
My name's Macaulay since I remarried.
Yes, of course. I'm sorry. Here.
Thank you. I caught the first flight down, and then there was a mix-up at the airport, first with the luggage and then with the taxi. How is she?
She's pretty bad.
Oh, my God. Have you seen her? Have they let you?
No, not yet. Dr. Hilton did say that he'd be down shortly. I'm hoping to see her soon.
Thank goodness you were with her at the time.
There wasn't very much I could do, I'm afraid.
Why, Greg? I mean, why would anyone want to kill her?
Connell then made a full statement in which he admitted intending to shoot Dr. Miller. Apparently, he was convinced somehow that you were responsible for his mother's imprisonment and for the shootout in which his mate was killed.
What'll happen now?
He'll be charged on both counts of murder. He'll probably plead insanity.
And get off, you mean?
Oh, no, he's not a well lad, Mrs. Macaulay. I doubt if he'll ever be released.
Greg, Mrs. Macaulay, could I have a word with you, please? I need your permission to operate again.
But you said Karen's too weak.
But she is. And I wouldn't want to operate under any other circumstances. But the fragments are moving closer to the heart. If we don't operate, she will most certainly die.
Mm-hmm.
some flowers.
Thank you.
How are you?
Well, I think I'm improving. I'm starting to feel uncomfortable.
That's a good sign. You've got a long way to go yet.
Look, I'm flying back to Queensland this afternoon, but I'm going to speak to Charles, and I want you and Greg to join us as soon as you're out of hospital.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Well, I'll go and find Sister and get her to put these in water.
Thanks, ma'am.
How good it is to see you looking so much better.
I've been waiting to see you all morning.
No more problems now, I promise. We're going to lead quiet, reputable lives.
Greg, can I ask you something? I'm going to be scarred, aren't I? All down my side and on my face.
Karen, my darling, that's the least of our worries. Just grateful to have you. Besides, that can be taken care of with skin grafts.
Really?
Yes.
I hope you don't think I'm being vain or stupid. I guess, under the circumstances, I'm just lucky to be alive.
It's a perfectly normal reaction.
Thanks. Greg?
Mm-hmm?
I love you.
I love you, too. Hey, got some news for you. Put the practice on the market this morning.
Already?
Don't get excited. It's not the most salubrious practice in town. We may have to wait a while. But I'll give Erica my notice. And by the time you're out of here, we'll be able to go to Queensland together.
Well, I better tell Angela pretty soon.
Well, you'll have no problem there. The halfway house, I'm amazed to say, is carrying on quite happily without you.
So you...